It's not a question that I've written down, but I actually want to ask you about that, because what I've noticed is that a lot of people just, when they find out, like, okay, I got to do something, they just do it by themselves. And they don't seek out, because there's a lot of professionals out there that are qualified, such as yourselves. What do you think makes people not actually look for the easy thing? And that's, you know, talk to you, because you got all the experience, you got all the knowledge. Do you think, what is that missing thing for people to say, okay, I'm going to search out the Adrians in the world and see how they can help me?
Well, part of it is, I think part of it is that people just don't know that there's another option. Like, we have been culturally indoctrinated in the fact that there is one way to care for your health. Your healthcare, you know, it's where you get your healthcare from, your healthcare practitioners, and having an alternative source outside of that, even your doctor, a lot of times, and now we're seeing a revolution where a lot of doctors are being more open-minded to it, especially the younger doctors, but even most doctors are saying nutrition is worthless. That's not going to help you. And the clients that I work with, they go back to their doctors and they're blown away. They don't know how this could possibly happen. And it's like, this is just application of nutrition and simple fundamentals of the way that the body works. The person's probably missing B vitamins. They have a gut imbalance. They have too much mercury in their system because they have mercury fillings, or, you know, there's so many just things that we just can easily look at. And there's a lot of research that shows us that these things impact the way that someone's body works. Like, if someone's drinking tap water, maybe they're just having a fluoride exposure that can create some negative side effects. And not saying that that's a cause of disease, but it's a contributing factor. And we need to really look at lifestyle from a holistic perspective. You know, stress levels, teaching someone how to manage stress is one of the most important parts of what I do, is saying, look, I can just see that you're, you know, starting your day very stressfully. You're just running out the door. You got all your kids. You're not giving yourself any time for you. You know, we need to focus on going to sleep a little bit early, getting up earlier. How many times does your doctor talk to you about that? But that's one of the most important parts of your health. So these things matter. And the reason that I'm so passionate about it is because I've just had some experiences myself. And I think everyone has, where when I was a kid, I was sick all the time. And the doctors never asked my parents about, like, my home environment. And it come to find out later on that there was just mold in my home. And this was like 5 or 6 years of just antibiotics all the time because I was always sick. It was an upper respiratory infection or some type of ear infection. I got hepatitis. I was just sick all the time. It's like, this isn't normal. Like, for a kid to be that sick, to be on allergy medication all the time, to have asthma, and all of my brothers were the same way. And it's just because we lived in an apartment that was mold infested. And I've had those situations where I've had clients come to me and friends come to me, and they're having children who have respiratory issues, and they're going for all these surgeries, all these medications. And I'm like, you need to get your air quality evaluated. And then when they do that, they find out there's mold. And it's like, well, that's the first place you have to look. If there's a respiratory issue, what is your child breathing in all day? It just makes sense. But for some reason, it's just the way that their training is, that when you go to your medical doctor, they're seeking a symptom to prescribe a medication for, and they are taught how to prescribe medications for certain symptoms. And they're really good at that. But if you want someone to really identify a solution, you need someone that's going to look at the entire picture and not just say, okay, well, you have asthma, let's put you on immunomodulators that shut down your immune system so they don't attack your lungs, and whatever's irritating your lungs just keeps irritating your lungs, but we just shut down the response that the immune system has that causes the bronchoconstriction in the asthma. It just doesn't make sense.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. Well, it keeps the economy alive, no? What the doctors are doing.
I mean, it does. Yeah, it keeps that portion of the economy alive. But I'm more concerned about keeping people alive. So that's why I took an alternative route. Clearly, the financial income that I make doing what I do because I'm early on is not what I could have done if I would have went the other route. But I'm building a business around more of a movement. So. You know, I think I'll make it work out for myself.
Absolutely. Yeah, no, absolutely. That's, I think it's the right path.